So today we are working with the ones and the tens for math, and it's actually really easy and fun. Wait for Wendell to get on. Hey, Wendell. All right, so we're working with ones and tens. And putting the two numbers together to get one number. All right.
Look at the big number.
What number is that? The yellow number. What number is this? Wendell?
35.
35. Thank you, Wendell.
35 stands for 3 tens and 5 ones. What numbers make up 35? The numbers 30 and 5 make up 35.
So when you're saying your numbers all the way to 100, you'll hear it. 35. 30 and 5 more is 35.
How are these numbers like the numbers in 3 tens and 5 ones? 3 tens is 30.
3 tens is 30. Think about 3 tens, counting by tens. 10, 20, 30. Excuse me. 3 tens is 30.
And 5 ones is 5. A digit is any of the numerals in a number.
A digit is any of these numbers. So the number 3 is a digit, the number 5 is a digit.
What are the digits in 35?
What are the digits in the number 35? Remember, a digit is any of the numbers in a number, the numerals in a number. So what are the digits in the number 35? Alana?
A 3 and a 5.
A 3 and a 5. Those are the digits that make up the number 35. Thank you.
The digits are 3 and 5. Which digit tells you how many tens in 35?
Which digit tells us how many tens are in the number 35? Now, Alana said there's a 3 and a 5. Those are the digits. So one of those numbers tells us how many tens are in that number. Wendell?
There's 3 tens and 1 5.
Yes, the 3 is telling us how many tens are in the number 30.
Select your answer.
So, Wendell said 3. I'm going to click 3 for him.
Three. Which digit tells you how many ones in 35?
How many ones? So we know there are 3 tens. How many ones are there? Amelia?
There are 5 ones. There are 5 and 35.
There are 5 ones. Yep, you got it, Amelia.
Five. use a model to show the tens and ones. When you use connecting cubes to show a number, you put the groups of 10 in the tens column on the place value mat. The leftover cubes are called ones. Where should you put these cubes?
So this is our chart to tell how many tens and how many ones are in a number. They group the cubes by 10, so you don't have to count by ones, you can count by tens. 10, 20, 30. There, that's 30 cubes right there. And then they're going to ask you some questions like, how many groups of 10 are there? So where should we put the leftover cubes? We already did the tens on the left side. On the right side is the ones. Where should we put them? Jaden?
You put them on the five. Yeah.
Well, there are five ones. You're right. But where should we put them on our chart over here?
In the number one.
Which side?
The side?
Yeah, this one is the tens and this one is the ones. So we need to put the five ones in the ones column.
You put the ones in the ones column on the place value mat. How many tens are there in 35?
How many tens are in the number 35? How many tens? So this is the group of 10. How many groups of 10 are in 35? Anyone thoughts? Wendell?
There are 10 threes in a cube, and there's five cubes for ones.
Yes, there are three groups of 10. So that must mean that there are three tens in the number 35. Three tens. 10, 20, 30.
There are three tens. How many ones are there?
Wendell already told us there were five.
There are five ones. You do not have to put cubes on a place value mat. You can also write numbers on the mat. The ones digit goes on the right. The tens digit goes on the left. You can put numbers on the mat instead of cubes. Three tens and five ones make 35.
So once you figure out your tens and ones, all you have to do is put the two digits together to make the number.
You can put the three and the five together to make the number 35. Now you know how to show tens and ones on a place value mat.
And I wish we could be in class and have more fun with these mats and cubes and big numbers. But as we're working with the tens and ones, I want you to remember that all of our teen numbers start with a one. And I've always told you that that one means that there's one group of 10 in the number. But that stands true for every number up to 100. The number that it starts with is how many tens are there. So in 35, three tens. In 42, four tens. In 55, five tens. So think about what the number starts with, and that'll be your tens. Are there any questions about today's math work? Wendell? Sorry.
I like math.
I know you do.
It's too easy.
It'll get harder. I hope you still love it. Any other questions about math today? Yes, this is nice and easy. I told you it was easy and fun. All right. You guys can go ahead and say bye to your friends.
Bye.
Bye, Amelia.
Bye.
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 Bye. Bye. Bye. I love you.
I love you, Wendell. And I miss you.
Yeah. Bye. Bye.